everybody, welcome back to my channel. This video is going to be my prom look. I'm not sure if I'll do another one, but I probably will. I know prom season is coming up and I am hectic doing makeup around my town, so it's really cool, but I just wanted to get this look up for you guys. And before I start, I obviously want to discuss the elephant in the room, which is my hair. Yes, my hair is blue slash silver ombre and I really love it, and I know you guys are probably going to be wanting a video on obviously how I got it like this, but I'm gonna save that for another video. I'm not sure when that will come. It's actually faded a little bit. It was a little bit more vibrant than this, but yeah, it was professional, so I have no idea how to explain how I got it, so I'm gonna have to do another video with my hairdresser maybe and explain how I got this color. But yeah, so this is my hair now. I just kind of wanted to explain what the deal was before I just popped in a video with blue hair and not saying a word. So yeah, please refrain from asking any hair related questions in this video because this is more about prom and the prom look that I did, and I don't want to, you know, all the questions to be about my hair. So just wait for the hair video. I don't know when it'll come, but just kind of hold back, and if you do have any questions, just go to my Tumblr and ask that. The link is always down below. And also, like, I had absolutely no idea what to do for this video because prom is so, like, personal. It depends on what dress you're wearing and everyone wears a different dress color, so I did this one pretty universal. All I'm doing is using one color that you may have. I use kind of a coral color, so if you have a coral prom dress, this will be perfect for you guys. But if you have a different color dress, all you have to do is switch out the coral color with whatever color your dress is, and hopefully that'll look good because I used black and a neutral color, so usually those two colors will go with just about any color. So if you have a blue dress, you know, swap out the coral for blue. If you have purple, you know, do the same thing. I tried to make it pretty universal in that way. So I really hope that you guys enjoy this video, and on to it.
So first things first, like always, we are priming the eyelids. I am using MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre, and I'm putting this pretty much all over the entire eye space. I am just doing this to cancel out any discoloration and also to make sure our eyeshadow stays on all night. Next, I'm applying some tape to the outer edge of my eye to get that really crisp and clean line because I just love how that looks. Then I'm taking NYX Jumbo Pencil in Cottage Cheese, which is a shimmery white base, because I wanted the inner half of my eye to be really, really bright, but this kind of made my eyeshadow crease a little bit, so I would have skipped this if I had known it would do that. Then from my Coastal Scents 252 Ultimate Eyeshadow Palette, I'm taking this shimmery champagne shade and placing this on the inner half of my eyelid. This particular shade had a slight gold tint, which was fine for this look because I'm using coral, but if you have a cool tone dress like a blue or a purple, I would use something that has a silver undertone and not a gold one. Ask me what I did with my life. Next, I am taking the color Naked from the original Naked palette, and this is just a medium toned matte brown, and I'm putting that on a MAC 217 brush and blending this in the crease and a little bit above the crease, and this is going to be our transition shade. As long as I got you. You want this color to be really, really soft and blended, so as you can see, I'm just doing windshield wiper motions back and forth, until this is perfectly blended. Then from the same Coastal Scents palette, I'm taking this shimmery coral shade and I am placing this on the outer half of the lid, but I'm still leaving a tiny little triangular gap right from the very outer corner to the coral. So we're not going all the way to the end with this, we're just doing a little strip kind of on the outer half. It's not very much the middle. Why can I not describe where this color is? Okay, but you just see what I'm doing. It's self-explanatory. Okay, anyways, now from Sigma's Smokescreen palette, I'm taking the black in that palette, and with a tiny, tiny brush, I'm filling in that tiny little triangular gap that we left, and I want this color to be very, very black, so just pack it on and use tiny little strokes, be very light-handed, and try to blend it into the coral and the Naked shade. We'll be right back. help out a little bit with the blending, I'm taking my 217 that had the naked shade on it and just kind of blending those two together. Now I'm taking the color right under the first color. This one is more of a matte shade of coral, and it was a lot more pigmented than the first one. So I'm using this color just for its color payoff, and I'm still having the sparkle shine through from the other coral. And now I'm just blending more, and then taking a smaller, more dense blending brush and continuing to blend that black out, because black is a tough color to blend, so just keep at it. As long as I got you, baby. Then I'm highlighting with this really opaque white that has a little bit of shimmer in it, but not much. And this doesn't look like the best highlight shade, but once it's blended out, it looks really nice. And we're gonna do some extra highlighting a little bit later. Now it is finally time to remove the tape, and mine was a bit too stuck on my skin. Even though I, you know, got rid of the tackiness before, I always seem to do that and the tape just doesn't want to come off my face. But once it is off, you can go ahead and take a makeup wipe and clean up any fallout, and then I'm going to go ahead and work on my face now. So I'm just moisturizing with my favorite moisturizer of all times, the Simple Hydrating Moisturizer, and then I will go in with a primer. I am using the Benefits Porefessional, and this is just going to fill in any pores that I have and make sure that my makeup lasts all night. And I was having a conversation with my sister here, so don't mind that. Then I forgot to show a clip of what foundation I was using, but I'm using my normal CoverGirl Outlast Stay Fabulous in 810 and dabbing this all over my face and then blending it out with my trusty old beauty blender. And also rude for being funny when I'm trying to be serious in film. Okay, so now I'm using MAC's Pro Longwear Concealer in NC15 to highlight my under eyes and my chin. And I added a little bit of this down my bridge of my nose and a little bit on my forehead as well. Then I'm going to go ahead and set those places that I put concealer with my e.l.f. HD Under Eye Setting Powder and my Real Techniques setting brush. If I lose my fame and fortune, really don't mind it. As long as I got you, baby. Clap your hands, drop so right. Clap your hands, drop so right. Clap your hands, drop so right. As long as I got you, baby. Clap your hands, drop so right. Clap your hands, drop so right. Clap your hands, drop so right. And then setting the rest of my face with my CoverGirl pressed powder. This seems like a ton of products, but I'm like barely even dabbing my brush into this product. Next, I'm filling in my brows. I'm using my Anastasia Brow Wiz in Ash Blonde and the Dip Brow in Blonde as well. And yeah, nobody got time for this on camera, so we're gonna move along to highlighting the brow bone. Oh look, I have eyebrows now. Okay, so I'm using Virgin from the Naked palette and just highlighting the very highest points of my brow bones and then applying some mascara. I'm skipping eyeliner for this look. You can go ahead and wear it if you want to, but I just didn't feel like doing eyeliner because the eyes were pretty dark anyways. So I'm just gonna add some fake lashes, which are really, really full and wispy, so it looks like I had liner on anyways. But yeah, so these are the lashes up close. Now we are putting that same color that we put on our lid, that shimmery champagne color, and applying this to the first half of the bottom lash line. And I'm also placing this in the very inner corner to brighten it up. It looks gorgeous in pictures when you have like a really bright color in that inner corner. Now I'm just applying some black eyeliner. This is Eclipse by Sigma, my favorite black eyeliner at the moment. And I'm just placing this on the very outer half and then blending it in with a little tiny pencil brush and just kind of blending it in with that first color so it looks nice and blended and there's no harsh lines or anything. You know the drill. Then I'm gonna give my bottom lashes a coat of this new mascara that I've never used before. Then I'm going to move right along to contouring. I'm using Hoola Bronzer by Benefit, and I'm using the brush that it came with as like a dupe for the Ida brush by NARS, but I don't think it really was a dupe because my contour was pretty harsh, as you can see, but you know, sometimes you just gotta make do with what you got. So I went ahead and blended that out. As long as I got you. Then for blush, I really didn't want anything over dramatic, so I just chose this really, really light, sheer, peachy toned blush, and I'm just placing this on the apples of my cheek and dragging it up along my contour. Even if you don't highlight every day, I really recommend highlighting your cheekbones for prom day so you look extra glowy in prom pictures. Trust me, it'll look gorgeous. I'm using Stila's Kitten Duo, and I'm using the Real Techniques Stippling Brush to apply this on the high points of my face. Then for lips, I chose to go with a nude lip simply because that's what I would wear to prom. I find it most flattering on myself, so that's what I went with, but you can do anything that matches your dress. So first, I'm just outlining my lips with this nude lip liner from Milani, and then I'm going to go over that with a MAC lipstick in Crimson Nude and making sure I really blend those two lines together so there's not any harsh lines around my lips and it's all very nice and blended together. And don't forget to bring your lipstick and your lip liner or lip gloss in your bag with you because you're most likely gonna eat it. What? Eat it? No, it's gonna come off when you eat. Don't eat your lipstick, people. So after that, you guys are all prom ready. You can put your dresses on and do your hair. I would have done a prom hair tutorial, but guys, let's be serious. I suck at hair. If you guys are wondering where my earrings are from, all that info will be in the down bar as well as all the products used in this video. So that is it. I hope that you guys wear this look at your prom. If you do, make sure you tag me on Instagram so I can see it. And yeah, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.